Philippine shares recover after declining on Monday, the main index gaining 0.4% to 64.29. Value turnover was over 5 billion pesos. To help us make sense of today's market movements, we're joined by Jovis Vistan of AB Capital Securities. Good afternoon, Jovis. Welcome to Market Edge.
Nice to see you, Stanley.
Nice to see you too. Now, Philippine equities recouping what it lost yesterday, moving against the grain, of course, from a largely down Asian market. What's pulling sentiment up?
Well, I think the market is just moving sideways nowadays, Stanley. Mm-hmm. After the strong earnings reporting season in the third quarter, that provided some support for share prices recently. So I think it was really follow-through selling because of the strong third quarter results. And the macroeconomic picture, on the other hand, was quite positive also for the Philippines, relatively speaking. And that sort of cushioned us from all of the noises from abroad. But even with the developments abroad, the expected spike in U.S. interest rates may have already been priced in, Stanley. So basically provided the positive backdrop for the past couple of days.
Okay, and perhaps another big elephant in the room, COVID-19 in China, casting uncertainty in most regional markets, even the U.S., owing to its almost irrational economy-busting response to the raging pandemic. I mean, is this a prevailing theme, you think, for Asian markets until we close the year? Unless, of course, China changes strategy.
Well, I think it's really isolated to China. Their policy is really a bit conservative. But eventually, I think in the medium term, given that most health officials globally have a better handle of the virus, I think it's not a major concern going forward.
Okay, and now Jovis, Goldman Sachs is saying the bearish global equities market is still finding a bottom with rising interest rates, of course, and economic deterioration pointing to a recession still. Now, we went from around 5,700 to 6,400 in Philippine equities in just a few weeks, or maybe even over just a month. Is there a reason to be cautious at these levels?
It was precisely because of the earnings study that we went up. There is definitely reason to be cautious. Interest rates haven't reached their terminal rate yet. We believe that rates will continue to go up to the first quarter of next year. The market cheered the inflation data that came out for October in the U.S. It was, if you look at it sequentially, it was up 0.4% as against expectations of 0.6%. But if you look at it in a deeper way, Stanley, actually that doesn't help in terms of achieving the target of the Fed, which is to achieve 2% year-on-year inflation. So we really have to see sequential inflation go down further to around 0.1 to 0.2%. So we still have a long way to go. So rates will continue to go up. In fact, if you look at the short and long-term yields, it's really inverted, and that's shouting out recession going forward. And if the U.S. goes into a recession, you're talking about one of the biggest trading partners of the Philippines along with China. That may have some impact down the road in our economic growth and consequently corporate earnings.
All right, short for saying inflation should be down before any rally could be convincing. Now, some corporate stories, Jovis, Cebu Pacific reporting third quarter operational losses from high fuel prices and, of course, a weak peso. As most airlines ranting about this, travel is back, but operating costs are high, tourism reopening, but fares not as affordable as before. Now, do you think Christmas travel season will alleviate fourth quarter or, of course, make a decent earning for airlines ending the year?
We're not certain yet because commodity prices have been volatile, Stanley, particularly energy costs. But on the demand side, in fact, Cebu actually announced that they're doubling their flights, both domestically and internationally. That's right. A good sign on the demand side. But the cost control side, I think, would be an issue that will remain.
All right, another corporate story. Alter Energy Holdings partnering with Shell for wind energy projects, bolstering Shell's stake, of course, in renewables. While initially targeting Mindoro, many more wind sites are to be explored. Now, how do you view this partnership, albeit the gains may be realized on a long-term horizon?
I think in terms of social responsibility, Stanley, I think going into renewables is the trend. And that would be, of course, the trend for the future. Mm-hmm. Right now, I think Italy, based on what we read from the prospectus, the first few years right now, it's a losing business right now. But eventually, since we're moving away from dirty fuel like coal and fossil fuel, coal being the majority of our source of energy, I think this is a right move for the company and also for the environment and eventually for the country.
Lastly, Jovis, Mondenisin was one high flyer when it launched, but recent stock performance, of course, reflect recent company developments with third quarter core EBITDA down 21% year on year. Now, while the stock is fundamentally sound, what catalysts do you think can bring back the Monday magic?
I think the magic was affected by the recall of their new boats that abroad. That unfortunate incident had a big hit in terms of their reputation and also in terms of their market share. So one major catalyst that they need to address is to improve their image and their product and make sure that nothing like this will happen again in the future. Also, I think in terms of managing costs, obviously Monday along with most of the companies were affected by rising input costs, management. Being able to maintain margins and improve on it, I think, will help a lot. Other companies like Century, URC was able to do that. I think Monday should be able to address that also.
All right. Jovis Vistan of AB Capital Securities, thanks for joining us, and thank you for your market guidance. Good afternoon.